In this video, we're going to look a little at animal phylogeny. We're going to take a look at the animal phylogenetic tree for the phyla that we're going to cover and some of the major traits that will fall on this tree. The traits we are going to look at are having true tissues, being diploblastic, being triploblastic, having bilateral symmetry, being protostomes, being deuterostomes, and ecdysis. The only trait we have not talked about so far is ecdysis. This is a process of molting or shedding a hard outer exoskeleton. In the next lessons, we are going to learn more about these phyla of animals. For now, I want to show you how clearly and easily these animal traits fall onto a phylogenetic tree. Our outgroup here is the periphera, the sponges. These animals do not have true tissue. That means we can add the trait true tissues on the tree in this location. Our next major innovation has to do with the number of tissue layers. Cnidaria are the jellies, corals, and sea anemones. They are diploblastic. All of our other organisms are actually triploblastic. The next major innovation is going to be bilateral symmetry. Most animals actually have bilateral symmetry. There are two groups that have radial symmetry, but it is a paraphyletic grouping. The cnidaria and ctenophores are the only two with true radial symmetry. Our next split has to do with embryonic development. We have a branch of protostomes, including most of the animals, and a branch of deuterostomes, which includes just the echinoderms and the chordates. This means that we are actually deuterostomes. Our last trait to add to the tree is going to be ecdysis. And this helps us split out these groups, nematodes and arthropods, from the platyhelminthes, annelids, and mollusks. So these two groups, nematoda and arthropoda, actually go through ecdysis, where they shed an outer cuticle or exoskeleton. So from this tree, we can see how many of these animal body plan characteristics, which are morphological, have been supported by DNA data and actually lead to this hypothesis of evolutionary history.